accepting the invitation for the 3-day online faculty program to build a learning culture based on collaboration, shared vision, and teamwork. Conducting from 24th to 27th May 2021, conducted by the S&H Department of St. Martin's Engineering College. St. Martin's Engineering College is a prestigious autonomous engineering college which has achieved the prestigious grade A+ from NAC from UGC Paramarsh Mentor, NBA accredited, ISO certified, DSIR recognition, remote center of IIT Mumbai. Member of CII and MSME certifications, 30 plus books, 6,228 plus research papers, and 98 plus patents published by staff and students. Institution has signed more than 88 plus MOUs with major companies and institutions. Best Engineering College of India by Career Connect and ranked 8th by Wikipedia in Telangana. The college is the recipient glorious Governor Award Prize. It is being declared as Best Sports College by STUMACH Telangana. National Leadership Excellent Award 2019 by ICCI. Recently, St. Martin's got place in NIRF ranking and also ATAL ranking from AICTE. Now, I cordially invite convener of this program, Dr. Randhir Reddy sir, professor and head of the department, Science and Humanities, will speak about this program.
Good afternoon. So, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Dr. Randhir Reddy, head of the Department of Science and Humanities, St. Martin's Engineering College, and convener of this 3-day FDP. I heartily welcome our college chairman, sir, Sri Murli Lakshman Reddy Garu, executive director, Chief Chandrasekhar Yadav Garu, respected principal, sir, Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra, sir, and the chief guest of the today's program, Professor Sumita Roy, former head of the Department of English and director, English Language Training Center, Usmania University, Hyderabad. And 3 days resource persons, Sharada Mani Nalla, Assistant Professor of from IFLU, Dr. Arul Nehru, Assistant Professor from NCERT, and different department, head of the departments, colleagues, and my dear participants. St. Martin's Engineering College was established in 2002. It was a UGC autonomous institution with NBA and NAC A+ accreditation. Our S&H department has successfully conducted in last academic year one international conference and AICT sponsored FDP and one 3-day faculty development program. In row and in this, in another notable achievement of S&H department, SMEC, during this pandemic second wave. Coming to this FDP, at first, let me appreciate you all for registering this FDP. I'm very much delighted to announce that 300 plus candidates have registered and expressed their interest to learn the learning culture together with the team spirit. Everyone knows about the global crisis of COVID-19, but you have proved that there is no pass of for updating your knowledge. So I congratulate all my department faculty members for their constant support. I also express my heartfelt gratitude to the management and our dear principal, sir, Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra, sir, for encouraging me and supporting me to conducting this 3-day FDP. Coming to the FDP, recognizing the importance of learning collectively as a team, this FDP is titled Build a Learning Culture Based on a Collaboration, Shared Vision and Teamwork. I assure you that this FDP can offer vital knowledge for the teaching faculty and as well as the student community. I convey my high regard to the 3 days resource persons, so for sparing their valuable time and accepting our request to grace this FDP with their enlightening tasks. I also express my best wishes to all the attendees and expect the same interest to join us in the future workshops, conference and FDPs. So thank you very much. So thank you from my end. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your best introduction of today's program. Leaders become great, but not because of power, but because of their ability. I take the privilege of inviting someone whose ideas have molded us. He is none other than our principal, Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra, sir, a recognized academician and educational administrator with the objective of producing the highest echelon of technocrats. Sir, with 18 years experience and his challenge to dream big, to work hard and endeavor for excellence, and to empower others to enjoy the journey every step of the way, made him scale greater heights. Under his excellency as a principal, innovative thinking, able leadership, meticulous planning, dynamism, dedication, diligence, and commitment have achieved great laurels for SMEC. He is holding BE, M.Tech, PhD and in Computer Science and Engineering. He has been honored with Governor Award thrice, Rashtriya Gaurav Award, Rashtriya Vikas Radhan Award, and Dronacharya Award. And Young Leader of the Year 2019 and IBAE International Award from Dubai. He has received 86 lakhs from DST, IIT Mumbai, and AICT. He has maintained the highest consultancy and industry-sponsored projects in Telangana, about 444 crores from GHMC Hyderabad. He's a UGC as a Paramus advisor, and he has facilitated 300 Akash tablets and from the IIT Mumbai. In his crowning glory, he has achievements like 12 books, 24 patents, 88 research papers, 16 magazine articles, and 138 newspaper coverage. He is on the editorial board of Tata McGraw-Hill International Publications. He is an achievement member of various technical educations from various countries like Canada, USA, Singapore, technical advisor for Alexa, Japan. Being a part of St. Martin's, we are very fortunate to have such a walking visionary to guide us in the right direction for achieving success in our attempts. Now, I would like to invite to our principal, sir, a navigator of this flagship of knowledge, to present the preamble of this program. Over to you, sir.
So thank you, Hemamika madam, for a brief introduction. So first of all, respected chairman, Sri M. Lakshman Reddy, sir, respected executive director, Sri G. Chandrasekhar Yadav, sir, and chief guest of today's program is Dr. Sumita Roy, who is the former professor and HOD of English department and director of ELTT, Osmania University, Hyderabad, and the convener of this program, Dr. Randhir Reddy, professor and HOD of S&H department, co-convener Dr. Hemambika, and program coordinator Dr. Venkanna and Dr. Sunil, and organizing committee members, advisory committee members, staff member of S&H department, last but not the least, participant and student across the country, a very good afternoon to all of you. I am Dr. Santosh Kumar Patra, principal of St. Martin Engineering College. Wholeheartedly, I would like to welcome you all to this national level 3-day faculty development program, which is titled as Building a Learning Culture Based on Collaboration, Shared Vision, and Teamwork, and which is scheduled for 3 days, that is from 24th May to 26th May. So today we are inaugurating, followed with we will have the first day session tomorrow, and the day after tomorrow will be there. At the outset, I would like to first congratulate all the participants for getting an opportunity to be a part of this great event. Because when we started doing the advertisement and we started doing the promotional activities and all, immediately we started a lot of responses. And to my knowledge goes, for this event, there are 311 registered participants are there, which is a remarkable achievement. Normally, if any event which is all organized by H&S department. So for this, I would like to appreciate Dr. Randhir Reddy for his effort and his entire team member who worked very hard to bringing out this idea into a reality. And today we could able to sit together, meet together, and it is like a collaboration celebration we are going to felicitate. And as I know, this is once we will recall the pandemic and all, so the lockdown was imposed in March 2020. And from that day onwards, if we will start counting, this is the sixth online event which is organized by S&H department. And I wanted to mention at this point that last five events were very grand success, and they had made a history in the St. Martin by inviting that much of participant for all this event. Still, I could able to recall when just 6 months before, when the S&H department had planned for an international conference, so more than 400 paper were registered, which is a history in my career too. So my appreciation to Dr. Randhir Reddy and the entire team of H&S department, who worked very well and collaboratively and coordinated very well, and brought this glory for their department as well as for the institution too. So in addition to that, I would like to convey my sincere appreciation and thankfulness to our chief guest of today's program, Dr. Sumita Roy. And we know you very well, madam, and you are a very good motivational speaker. In fact, after my speech, I wanted to join as a participant and listen to you, because some of your videos are very popular. In fact, I was waiting for an opportunity to see you, meet you, and spend some time. And this event gave me an opportunity to spend some time with you. And one of your popular video, which is best way to speak English. So I know that more than 6 lakhs viewers are there through online. And there is another video of yours that is develop effective English speaking, which is also very much popular, not only in India, across the globe. So we are really fortunate. And we are very much thankful to you. With a small span of notice, you agreed and you have given your kind consent to be with us. We are very happy for that. And as the title suggests, it is related to building a learning culture based on collaboration, shared vision and teamwork. And anyway, madam is there to tell us a lot about it. And there are very good resource persons which are all taken, who are all best in academics, to nurture the skill set of all the participants. But what I understood with the meaning of this culture of collaboration means it is a collaboration of staff and student and parents. It is normally I say it as in a triangular shape, where the collaboration has to take place properly. And I strongly feel collaboration cannot be compelled. So what the leaders who are all there, and they must help all the members to feel a sense of pride and ownership of the assigned work. Then only the concept of collaboration can be taken it to the next level, and the leader could be of any form. For a particular class, the class teacher is a leader. And for a department, the department HOD is a leader. And for the college, deans are there, principals are there, they are the leaders. So they need to shoulder the responsibility and disseminate the flagship of knowledge in such a way that everybody should feel that they are the owner of their particular work. But however, I strongly feel there are some tips which everybody can follow to have a collaboration with the staff, student and parents. And some of them I would like to mention here at this junction. Like, we all should have a clear focus on what should be the outcome of this collaboration and this work. And we need to expand the leadership opportunity among all stakeholders and create a meaningful opportunity for the work and coordinate efforts and celebrate the work of others. So there should not be any jealousy by seeing the others' achievement and the success story. We need to celebrate their success so that in a team, so when our success will come, so everybody will be celebrate that. And the title also suggests about the shared vision. So what I strongly feel, a vision should be created collaboratively in a culture of openness to learn. And also it should be a belief that all the stakeholders should be successful by a part of this vision. And the vision provides a reference point for all the decisions about literacy and numeracy, which includes about the curriculum, pedagogy and resourcing, and professional development, students' collaboration and communication with the parents. So these are all small notes. I thought, no, it should be, no, got it to the notice of all the participants, and many of you might be knowing about it. But let us inculcate these habits of doing the best, the profession what we have chosen for our career. So that creates a lot of harmony in the profession and also bring a lot of glory for the success too. And also I would like to mention all of you, anyway, basically, we all are teaching professional. We are all teachers and students. So every day is in a learning opportunity for us. Every day we learn. And all these events like the workshops and faculty development program, STTP, which are all organized, it provides a platform for us, which I would like to narrate you in the form of a small story. So we all know about the shark fish. And even if in our home also we have the aquarium and we used to keep the shark fish. So if we will see the size of the shark fish in our aquarium, it is somewhere maximum it grows up to 8 inches. So the same shark fish, let us pick it up from the aquarium and put it in the sea or a big river. We will able to see the same shark fish will able to grow from 8 inches and it goes up to 8 feet. So same fish. So what is important? The atmosphere, the learning atmosphere is important. So this platform will give you that kind of opportunity to expand your knowledge matrix in not only in a vertical way, also in a horizontal way. And to inaugurate that, we have our chief guest today with us, Dr. Sumita Roy, which is really going to justify the objective of this faculty development program, which is all planned. So again, at the outset, I would like to appreciate the department, especially Dr. Randhir Reddy and the entire staff member of S&H department and the chief guest of today's program. And last but not the least, all the students and the participants across the country. Thank you very much for listening to me. Thank you for the opportunity. Do take care of yourself and have a great day ahead. Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity.
We are indebted for your great words. You have been a constant motivator and mesmerizes the audience with style and substance. Thank you very much, sir. Every thought you produce, anything you say, any action you do, it bears your signature. It's very happy to welcome our chief guest by reading ma'am's profile, Dr. Sumita Roy. She's a retired and head of the department English and director English Language Training Center, Usmania University, Hyderabad. Professor has 30 years of undergraduate and postgraduate teaching experience, 31 years of pursuing research, 24 years of research supervision. She guided 15 PhDs and 12 MPhil scholars, principal investigator for 3 research projects sponsored by UGC and MHRD MOOCs projects. Visited 15 countries like United States of America, Bangladesh, Germany on academic and other assignments. Madam has worked as a director, Usmania University Center for International Programs, executed MOUs with USA, Canada, Norway, Germany. In 2006, conferred with Books on Books Award by the Federation of Indian Publishers, New Delhi, for publication entitled Never Say No to Life. She honored with various positions like Head Department of English, Usmania University, Director for English Language Training Center, Usmania University, Director of OU, Canadian Studies Center, Editor, Member in Publications Committee, and Chairperson, Academic Coordinator. She worked as a Principal Investigator for various projects. Madam has published 47 books, 52 articles in national and international journals. She has delivered around 300 lectures in UGC refreshers courses, orientation programs, workshops, seminars, etc. Guest lectures delivered more than 1,000, worked as PhD examiner for almost 15 universities all over India. Thank you for accepting our request, and we are fortunate to have you here in today's program as chief guest. All of us undoubtedly will enjoy and learn from you words. Now I would like to invite Dr. Sumita Roy ma'am to deliver her views regarding this program. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you and namaste to all the participants. I hope audio is clear. I must start by congratulating the college, its principal, the HOD and all the organizers, including the lady who introduced me, because you have planned a program which is really very worthwhile. Today, I'm reminded of a very famous saying by Alvin Toffler, the great thinker. He said that in the 21st century, a person who is illiterate doesn't mean that he or she doesn't know how to read and write. Usually we think illiterate means cannot read and write. In the 21st century, a person who's illiterate, he says, does not know how to learn, relearn, unlearn. Three words are used, learn and unlearn and relearn. These are the three things if we don't have in this 21st century, that means we are illiterate. Now we have seen that within two decades of the 21st century, we are now faced with a huge challenge, and that is the pandemic that is going on. Now in the pandemic, there are both negatives and positives. So it is teaching us many things, learn. We have to forget many of the traditional things. So we have to unlearn and we have to relearn what we knew thousands of years ago in our country. We are learning once more. So you can imagine what Toffler said in the 20th century is applicable today. I think that is very relevant for the program which you have organized for these 3 days. Because when we talk about collaboration, when we talk about shared vision, or when we talk about teaming, these are the ideas that come to my mind. The word collaboration has become very significant today because we have online resources. If I or, you know, you as faculty members of different colleges write a paper and it is available on academia.edu, you might get responses from all over the world. It is not like the printed article or the printed book which we had when I was a young scholar. Today we have a global audience and we have a global collaborator also. Seeing what you have done, the work you have done, people might like to collaborate with you. You might do a joint project without meeting each other ever. Like today I'm not in St. Martin's College, I'm at home, but I'm collaborating with all of you in the shared experience of ideas. So learning, very significant. Now, teamwork also is very important because the pandemic has shown us that no individual is important. It is not as individuals, as a team, you know, the medical professional, for instance, one doctor is not enough, one specialist is not enough. We are talking in terms of huge numbers here. The entire world is collaborating because a single nation is not able to cope. So you can see the possibilities of teamwork. Then we have sharing. Sharing is so important today because not only are we sharing knowledge, but we are also sharing experiences. This is called as vicarious experience. The teacher and the student shares experiences in the classroom, in the teaching learning context. And no teacher, I'm sure, who's attending today can say that they did not learn something from their students. We all learn, we teach our students, but we also learn a lot from them. So sharing becomes significant. Now, what we would like to do in this process, you know, when you're talking about shared vision, I would like every student and every faculty member who's here today, you know, you might be directors and principals, you might be classroom teachers, you might be students in the first, second, third, or fourth years. Whoever you are, start experimenting, you know, for collaboration, for teamwork or sharing, or for having any kind of vision, what you require is experimenting. Unless we experiment, we cannot go forward. So in a FTP program like this, what you are taught is that you can experiment. Where is the laboratory for your experiments? It is here. You have an inbuilt laboratory where you can experiment to the ultimate till you come across wonderful ideas. A shared experiment would mean a group of people who have put all their points, all their ideas together, and they are all working towards it. Then we have another, apart from experimentation, we have another important concept, and that is expansion. Expansion would mean that we should not be locked up in small compartments. You know, collaboration again. We should be able to move globally. We should be able to disseminate. As your principal was suggesting, you know, I spoke in some small program, maybe 50, 100, 200 people were there. I shared some ideas which were uploaded by somebody, and now it has millions of views. I cannot, you know everybody, but we are collaborating because that person's feedback, that person's comment would make a joint project. The project of learning becomes a joint one. It doesn't remain with any one of them. So expansion is very important. One example of expansion, which I would like to give you here, is the movement from the physical to the digital classroom. Now all of us know it. On 25th March 2020, it was a very difficult concept. Many research papers came out saying online education is not possible. Today we have the blended mode. Blended would mean that we are putting them both together, physical, digital, 40% online and 60% offline. Of course, when the pandemic is over and we can meet face to face. So what are we doing? We are expanding. We are collaborating. We have to constantly move with each other. This expansion becomes very important. So what we require to do is to collaborate, to do work in teams, and to prepare a vision, which are all keywords in your title. What we need to do is we have to combine the traditional with the innovative. The teaching learning process. Here I would like to remind you that learning is not limited to the syllabus or the classroom. Learning is a lifelong process which goes on throughout our life from all experiences which we undergo. So our shared experiences, where with your family, with your friends, with your colleagues, your teachers, your administrators, your bosses and subordinates, everybody, whatever experiences we are sharing with them, become a part of our learning experiences. Very often we have to unlearn and relearn also, like Alvin Toffler has told us. So learning, unlearning, and relearning. Now I would like to spend a couple of minutes only to give you some examples of this. I've given you a few things: experimenting and expansion. Then I've said physical and digital blended. Then I've also said traditional and innovative. If we combine all this, we come to all the keywords that are there in the topic of the FTP now. As an English teacher, I would like to just mention to you a few examples, which, you know, in a couple of minutes I can finish and then go on. Because all of you are not English teachers, you will have to experiment. Madam who read out is chemistry, I'm told. So in chemistry, I'm sure you will find wonderful examples like what I'm telling you. One is, number one, peer teaching and learning. During my headship, I used to make the students of MA previous and MA final teach English to MA students of other departments: political science, history, economics, public ed, All these students want to learn English because they are most of them rural students. Who can teach them? Those who are doing MA English, they are still students in Arts College, but they can teach peer learning. So your own friend teaches you. This is very, very powerful, and it is wonderful experiment which all of you can try with your own subjects. Then group activities, say you want to teach somebody vocabulary. Then what you can do is divide them into small groups, give a word which is spelled out. You're teaching spelling and you're teaching vocabulary. Then the group tries to guess. You know, every word has vowel sound. So they'll say A, E, I, O, U. Like that, you give them 20 chances. When they guess the word, they have to tell the meaning and make sentences. Then you have dumb charades, you know, without opening your lips, you have to show. So you want to teach idioms or proverbs. You know, a bird in hand is worth two in the bush. So without opening your mouth, you show a bird and, you know, you show the hand and so on till the other team guesses it. These are all examples of collaboration. The teacher is only helping. Teacher is only facilitating. The students are all learning together. Of course, team teaching is where two or more teachers can share the topic which is going to be taught today. I remember my colleague and I used to do it in the early 90s. In different FTPs, we showed them how team teaching can be done. Unfortunately, today we are not able to meet face to face to show what is team teaching. But I saw that one of the lectures is on this. This is a wonderful area. If you have two or three members in your own subject, you can always do team teaching. Students can participate in that team, and it becomes like a discussion forum. It becomes a wonderful point. Then you can have pair work. You know, suppose you want to teach LSRW, listening and speaking. Then you can do pair work. You tell two people, one tell a story, like your principal told us a story now. Now, if I ask all the 300 participants to narrate what the principal has said, you will get different versions, listening and speaking. So paired work, one person whispers in another person's ear, the second person tells it aloud, you know, becomes collaborating. And these are very exciting activities for all students. Then you can have a chain or a stream work. Suppose you divide the whole class into, you know, one row and you say, first student tells the second, I admire you, and gives one word. I admire you for your intelligence. So they are learning new words. You know, I admire you for your poise, somebody says. Now, poise might be a new word for everybody. Then they feel excited to learn new words. In this way, English can be taught because everybody needs English these days. I have given you all examples from English. But I would be very happy if after this FTP, each attending person, teacher or student, makes a few, you know, at least five exercises like this for collaborative learning and tries it out in a classroom. That will be the real outcome, you know, the takeaway from this FTP. We all need takeaways from things. So thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. I feel very happy. I took 15 minutes instead of taking 10 minutes. I hope the organizers don't mind. Thank you and namaste.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for your valuable information. We came to understand what is a learn, unlearn, and relearn during this period of a short period of time. Thank you so much, ma'am. And now this is a time of vote of thanks on behalf of St. Martin's Engineering College and the entire management group here. I'm very much happy and gratitude to our Chairman Sri Marilakshman Reddy Garu, Executive Director Sri G. Chandrasekhar Yadav Garu for their great support. And we are very thankful to the presidential speech by our dynamic principal, Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra sir, for sharing their graceful words with us in today's program. The honorable and respected chief guest, Dr. Sumitra Roy, director, head of the department English from Usmania University, for sharing her ideas and experience with us in today's program. It has been our tribute to host all the members, and I'm thankful to all the participants for coming here and attending the faculty development program. We have seen fortunate to have all the renowned identity from academic and industries and other areas. I'm very much thankful to the entire participants of this meeting. I'm sure that our college will continue to get significant provision from the diverse programs in the future. With the few minutes, the session one going to be conducted, please be patient.
Okay, I will hang up now.
Yeah, thank you very much, Madam. Sundita Rai, Madam.
Okay, namaste and all the best for your sessions.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. So session one will start after 5 minutes. So please be online.